Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Mario&Luigi Superstar Saga. Last time, Mario fell in the giant barrel of Chocola, and so now we are solo Luigi. Solo Luigi, if you will. And it's going to be a little annoying because we have to fight solo. And I still don't know these goddamn Chuck guys' pattern. I'm just getting lucky. We don't have the powerhouse of Mario, but at least we don't have to worry about getting killed, because Luigi is one tough mofo. He's going to last, and I've got dozens of mushrooms, so I'll be fine on healing. Also won't be able to do any special moves. I'm limited to just my jump and hammer, because those are bros moves, and I do not have my bro with me. I do like how he shouts, "Go, Luigi," when you go into a battle. I don't know. It's just a little touch that I like. When you think about it, though, what else are they gonna do? If you don't have Mario. I suppose Luigi's strong enough to be able to get through here with relative ease. And now Luigi's going to get more experience than Mario, so he's going to level up quicker after all this. Yeah. That's weird. You press B to attack because you're Luigi, but then you press A to scroll through the thing. I don't know, it's confusing me. I say you should be able to do that with both A or B. Well, either A or B. I messed up here before. I hit one, then I hit the other, then I had to go back between them. And I didn't get as much coin. It was pretty interesting, though. Yes! Let's push this down into the water. And hop on it. Ah, Luigi. Well, if you think about it, we do need to get this Chocola Cola to the Queen. So, he's sitting on it. And, oh, now Mario is full of Chocola Cola. Well, look at this guy. A very Mario-esque fellow and a some other guy. Oh, poor Luigi. What? What is it? Mario's guts is filled to the brim with Chocola Reserve. It's sloshing around inside. Gross! That is absolutely disgusting. That's terrible and sort of disgusting. We must contact Lady Lima immediately. By the way, what's Chocola Reserve? Shh, I have no idea. Oh, goddamn these guys, they know nothing. They're like me. Queen Bean has been in a deep sleep, just as you see her now. Did you truly obtain some of the legendary Chocola Reserves? Is that her voice? I don't know. Whatever. Let's jump. That's kinda nasty. Blarf? Oh, gross. It's the black worm. There's the belly black worm. And now she's going away. I say kill it. But fine. Hey! Now the queen gets turned back to herself. Okay. Oh, truly a success. A truly repugnant, yet truly tremendous success. Truly tremendous indeed. Queen Bean has returned. Duh. Oh, that was the hardest I've laughed in a long, long time. Well done, Lady Llama.
I'm giving Queen Bean a very deep voice. Just for kicks and giggles. Mostly giggles.
No, Your Highness. It is not I, but rather the Mario Bros who you must thank.
Give us money.
So Capuleta has stolen Princess Peach's voice and the Beanstar. Wait, Beanstar?
Sorry, I had to get that in there.
It was my fault. Nonsense. But why would Cacoletto steal the Beanstar and Princess Peach's voice in the first place?
Does it grant wishes? She could wish you all dead. Or she could possibly wish for a few cupcakes. That's what I'd wish for. The Beanstar is the protector of this land, and it has the power to grant any and all desires. All desires. So that's a lot of cupcakes. To prevent such power from being used for evil, the Beanstar was cast into a deep sleep. It's said that the voice of a great beauty is required to wake the bean star from its slumber. You know, a question occurred. Why did they still teach Peach's voice, not just Peach? I know it's kind of neat, but still. It would have been the same motivation. It must be the voice of a pure and noble soul. In this day and age, Princess Peach is the only one who possesses such a voice. Although the exploding text, it was kind of hilarious. Okay, I'm glad they did that. I like that picture. So the reason Cacletta stole Princess Peach's voice... Ah, she must plan to awaken the Bean Star. The Bean Star! And fulfill all of her desires. And there's no mistaking her one true desire, to rule the world. The cliche of any evildoer.
Ho ho ho. Fear not, I foresaw this desire of her long, long ago. We are prepared. Card for card, we have a better hand than she.
Your Highness, Prince Peasley has arrived. Oh god, no, not fruitcake.
Perfect timing. Master Mario, Master Luigi, head out to meet Prince Peasley.
I forgot what voice he has. Anyway, now we have... No, wrong button. Now we've got both Mario Bros back, and Luigi, you don't get to be in the front. Let's go meet Prince Peasley. And here he is. Cheers to Red and Greeny. Thank you for helping me earlier. Yes, thanks to you, my secret mission is about to pay off. I don't know if the music that makes me want to do the voice. I like the music.
Prince Peasley, excellent work on your mission. Have you learned the whereabouts of Cacletta?
Thanks to you? Absolutely. Southwest of this castle is hoohoo university, our local research institution. Cacletta and her underlings have just snuck into there, into Woohoo University.
Hooniversity.
All these laugh puns.
Yes, of course, Woohoo University is the perfect place to awaken the Bean Star.
I intend to march into Woohoo University right this instant. Okay, stop saying it. I know where it is, or what it is. Well, I know where it is. May we meet again. Hopefully not, but probably yes.
Master Mario, Master Luigi, this may be your chance to recover Princess Peach's voice.
Oh, sweet.
I shall inform the locals that you are allowed to passage to the road to Woohoo University.
Well, awesome. And that's just what we're here for, to get Princess Peach's voice back. Once we have that, everything will be good. Well, maybe Bowser. Nah, do we really need Bowser? I mean, he just causes trouble. He doesn't really do anything helpful. Hey, speaking of helpful things, here's the shop. Let's stock up on supplies, or at least see if we need to. Hey, one-up mushrooms. They're kind of pricey, but probably worth it. How many of these? 46 mushrooms, 22 syrups, 11 refreshing herbs. I'll get... three. There we go. That should be good. And let's sell our... Let's see. Our spike badge. Because we have got a lot of those. Let's see. We've got one equipped, so we can sell three. Alright. Because I don't intend to use and more than one. Just for Mario, because Luigi's going to need, like I've said, I've explained this before. Hey, a new enemy! This is Lakapi, the Bean Bean version of Lukitu. And they throw the Bean Bean versions of Spinies, the Sharpies. Ah, oh, cursed Sharpie. I'm gonna jump on this Lakapi, because it can throw out more Sharpies. It's good to have the powerhouse Mario back. And this should kill it. Or not. Stop. Have a time. terrible jokes. And, oh yeah, they dropped Sharpies in the field. Wait, can I find another one? Because I kind of want to show something. Let's see. This isn't the way we're supposed to go. Haha, wait. I want to, curses. Okay, forget that. What I was going to show is, if you jump on it, well, you've got the spike badge as Mario. They're so weak that Mario could just one-shot them. It's really nice. Hey, it's one of those things. So let's dig us a bean. Yes, let's just do things. And now into the new area with new, more enemies. That's a swarm, not worth our time. Enemies that are, like, really weak and we're not going to really benefit from. We're not supposed to be here yet. That's a training ground with some quite high-level enemies. We could take them on. They wouldn't be that much of a problem, but I don't really need to grind, as you've seen. Have we seen these par beans? Par beanies. I'm pretty sure we have, considering how easily. Here we go. New enemy. This is a troopy, the bean incarnation of Koopas. Oh well, technically Koopa Troopas, because there's different kinds of Koopas. Like there's Koopa Troopas, Paratroopas, other things. Did you hear that? Listen, that was me getting a text message. I'll check that later. Isn't that one of the greatest ringtones ever? I order you to go and make that your ringtone now. Direct order from Thrasho 2. Do it. You will follow my orders. Oh, right. Troopies can heal themselves. I neglected to mention that. Yes, they can heal themselves or others. That's their kind of thing. Hey, and here's Luigi's level. But yes, you will follow my orders. Go, do that. Pause the video and go make your ringtone Navi. Any incarnation of Navi. Whether she's saying, hey, listen, or watch out. I can't do it very well because my voice does not go high at all. My voice...
I can make my voice go very, very low.
As you've seen with Queen Bean. Seen with Queen Bean. As seen with Queen Bean. That should be a talk show. That would be awesome. And... yeah, we've got time. I'll make it to the next place and then call this a video. I've got a lot of things to cut out. Like random battles and such. So what have I been doing recently? I have been watching Sweeney Todd with Freakish Ken or Rachel or whatever she wants to be called. I don't think she cares. You know, die. You know, I've mentioned her before. British chick, nice rack, you know. But anyway, we've been watching Sweeney Todd. I've only seen like half of it so far, but I'm liking it. And from what I understand, he kills people and makes them into pies, which is both devious and delicious. Woohoo Hooniversity is this way. I cannot swim, sir. I do not have the flippers. Because apparently, according to Nintendo logic, if you get flippers, you can instantly swim. Even though you've drowned before. We can't even go into the water. Anyways, Sweeney Todd! She's been recommending this film for a long time, and I'm glad I finally get to see it. Oh, it is hilarious. It's also got Johnny Depp in it, one of my favorite actors. Possibly my absolutely favorite actor. And, okay. Well, we're gonna end it off here. We're going to go into Hooniversity, or whatever. So, be cool, save often, and don't do anything I wouldn't.